I am the life.
Life.
I am the
Life.
very
That's
life.
the life for now.
Yay, Dinkum.
Dinky.
I ask the Dinkums.
Thank you.
I likes the Dinkums. I am streams the Dinkums. The captions don't know what to make of me when I'm doing a silly accent like that. Hello.
Couldn't
Oh
hear you.
no, I can hear myself. That's horrifying. Hello. Chat, Damin. Damin chat. As if I don't know most of you very well. Hello and welcome aboard. I have thrown away all of the old music, and now we have new music. Just setting it up. Raid message. Ready for the end. But we don't focus on ends, we focus on beginnings. I have played with my settings. The scrolly, horrifying screen has gone away. I liked it, but also I wanted to make it better, but also I have no idea how to use Blender. And when I say that, I mean literally no idea. And also the visualization I was using to make the white lines, yeah, it kind of didn't really work very well. Hello, Spetro. How are you doing? I'm hoping I pronounced that correct. Thank you for coming over in the raid and bringing the raid message. I appreciate you. Right, let me turn me capture on. Where's me capture? There we go. So I have been playing with all of the ting, so now I have captions in case anyone would like to try and allow captions to guess what I might be saying. It could, of course, force me to enunciate more just so the captions try and work, but I don't know. Hello, Enrix. How are you doing? And a single cactus as well. What? You were battling? How very dare you do things for yourself? It's absolutely such an offense that you would dare enjoy yourself in your own personal time off. We are the Dinkin. I have spent some of the last 2 days. Well done on winning the battle. I have played one battle, lost it completely, didn't even win one single matchup. They just wiped out every single Pokemon and decided I have no idea what I'm doing and to avoid it. Snowy was returned. He was posted back. Lilo does not believe it, but it did happen. No, I haven't gone out looking for dogs again, I'm afraid. What I have done, however, is I have built a windmill. Windmills increase the efficiency of some of these, but not all of them. Furnaces, yes. Grinders, yes. And barbecues, yes. But I don't think it does table saws or grinders, but I put them there because I wanted to put it all the way around anyway. In an 11 by 11 grid around it, it increases the efficiency of the machines. So making a little floor area for it here. And some of this is going to go away. And I've adjusted my orchard a bit. I decided I wanted a wider path, which is going to be blocked in by yellow wattles. in a big old grid. And I also learned from doing the mass harvest that it's actually better to be able to walk down and right click as you go. So I've adjusted my grid so it's 2, 2, 2, although I haven't done it for the coconut trees yet, because the coconut trees I don't have enough of really to kind of throw away yet. Because of course when you hack them to pieces, they get thrown away. I've also learned the ratios of what the trees drop. So these drop 2. These drop 3. And this drops 4 fruits. So for every one of these, I need 2 of these to equal up. And I need 1.5 of these. So I'm going to have to play with my ratios, because I want to be able to harvest an equal number of each fruit at the same time. Because that can then be crafted into fruit salad, which makes you about 15% more money at the shop for making it overall. Or I may just sell it all straight anyway. But yeah, so I'm gonna build out the orchard a bit based on those ratios. Not that I have actually worked out what that means in terms of... So I'll probably have to spreadsheet the heck out of it. Everyone loves a good spreadsheet. It'll probably mean 4 rows of apples to 8 rows of bananas to 6 rows each of kwangdongs and limes. Off the top of my head. Yeah, why not? Why not post a picture of the spreadsheet? If we're going to spreadsheet the heck out of something, then we can post spreadsheets. 6 rows and 6 columns, rather. And then the rows are going to be... I could do 12 and 12, which would be 24. But then, of course, it's by 12 or 24, which just makes the maths a bit harder. So I was thinking I would do 15 and 15, or 10 and 10. Probably 15 and 15. So with that basis, what we could probably do is fire up a bit of Excel now. Excel does show my real name. Okay, we can't put Excel on stream. It shows my real name. Not doing that. Just have to play it out and hope I don't heck it up. So the only thing I haven't figured out is coconuts. I think coconuts are 3 as well. So that means I need 6 rows of coconuts, 6 rows of kwangdong, 8 rows of bananas. Four rows of apples. So I'm not far off from being able to do most of that without a lot of work. Common blue tail. Oh. Outside is overrated. I don't recommend it. Get a job working from home. Never leave. I do, however, wish you the good sleeps. Sleep well. Yeah, job with egg days for the win. I heard about this online website that sells basically everything. Most of it dodgy, cheap imported stuff. It's named after one of the rainforests. What's it called? Oh, that's right. You work for them. You could buy from them instead of outsiding. Never know, it might work. Is that a cat doing a face palm? If so, spot on. Oh, one of my other catch-up comments from while Lilo was talking and I was driving was going to be about professions, walk of life for Stardew. So Lilo had previously had expressed thoughts to me about doing a big time automation, min-maxing run, massive farm, tractor mod, that kind of stuff. I was gonna add professions, walk of life and the look mod into that, because that would add a lot of depth, especially with the artisan bonuses for making your goods better. So I think it's a good fit for that. Oh, a shiny disc. And yes, by all means, post the interesting stuffs. I mean, I was enjoying it in my playthrough for sure. Sleep well. Please do sleep well. Yes, have a great day. I kind of like that I found music that doesn't actually crash my OBS, but at the same point, this is a bit too chillaxed. I want rock music today, I think. No! Dig, dig. I really am a dwarf digging a hole. Oh, I did some fishing again yesterday as well, and I don't like it. You have to find the fish, which, you know, is the challenge in itself. And then, of course, they move around a lot, so you have to keep moving. It's just, I never really am a huge fan of the fishing mechanisms, let's put it that way. I will possibly attempt to do as much of it as I can just to complete the museum, because there are bonuses for doing so. But I doubt it'll be central, and I don't say that in a way to say that this game is particularly onerous. Actually, it's not too bad in terms of the fishing mechanism. It would probably be a lot of fun for the right person. It's just not for me. Never have been the hugest fan of the fishing mechanisms. As good as Stardew is, I wouldn't even call that fishing mechanism bad. I just don't like fishing in games, it seems. Possibly because I used to fish in real life and I don't really like that either. You certainly can't volume fish in Dinkum. If you go out for a day fishing, you're probably only going to catch two or three. And that's mostly just because of the going and finding them aspect of it. And your overroom is wearing off. Well, I did turn off the light so you can go and lie down. And, you know, I can just try and talk a bit more quietly into the room. I mean, that's not that possible for me because I am a loud boy, but still. I can the try. You should at least lie down until your next one's due at noon. Lilo is stubborn. Even though I've got a mod that auto, a bot that auto mods, she insists on staying here. It is okay, Lilo. Take care of
that's what I always wanted. I will name him George, and I will hug him and pet him and squeeze him.
Thank you. I don't currently have the lay cat cam. Or one for you to save your points up for, Fairy Godmother. But please do enjoy a lurk. Oh, okay, hang on. There we go, I type it. I type it. Oh, I will hydrate, thank you very much. It is always a good idea to hydrate. I've not seen fish spawn in this yet. That stretch has got the wrong icon. It's got the Twitch hedgehog on. I need to fix that. Oh yeah, just for me. That's weird. That must be a firebot heckup then. Because I get nothing for Adrian's of hydrate. I think I'm gonna shake up my hydrate one, and I'm gonna change the sound clip for it. I don't know what to. I mean, I do like that one, but I'm thinking about changing it up. And I did have one in mind, and now I've forgotten it. Yeah, I'm going to have to start actually farming crops soon. But I think I have to wait now until summer to get watermelons to make scarecrows. Apparently both kangaroos and birds can eat your crops. Yes, I may well do some of that as well. I'm probably going to get to the point where I zoo every animal using a cage to go and get them. Real life water, I am good, thank you. Oh look, McDonald's app is saying that I can have a new app offer today for trick or treat. Yeah, man, let's check this. A Herdier. It looks like it's a Rock Ruffs upgrade, maybe? I'm not entirely sure. But, I mean, you know, it's Pokemon. I've also moved the Pokemon a bit more, so now it looks like I'm gonna, like, half eat it. I don't really know why I did that. It seemed like fun though. Look, I've moved the Pokemon a bit.
That's not bad.
I think it is. She is the best future wifey. I am very lucky. Good luck, Persephone. I hope your Pokeball. I hope your Pokeball brings you great luck. I used to go gung ho with the Great Balls myself until I added it as a streamer. Oh, I was going to put Stream Raiders on today as well. That went well for me. I don't even have it installed right now. Does anyone hear Stream Raiders? Because if you don't, there's not a lot of point in me putting it on, in fairness. You have a grievance about your glasses.
They have stupid squares there.
They've always had those squares there. I'm sorry that you hate the squares that have always been there on the glasses that you picked. You will be due your eye test in the new year, though, anyway, won't you?
Has this seriously been there the whole time?
They have seriously been there the whole time.
Ew.
The whole time you've had glasses, you've had those little squares. Yeah.
I hate that.
I mean, yeah. Fair enough. Well done, Persephone. Your great ball did have all the luck. You just said the word Persephone.
But I have to hear you say it.
I believe the Persephone is the name of the car that Homer designs and bankrupts his brother Herb with. Or it's one of the names suggested until he, you know, turns it into a terrible, terrible thing. No, wrong hole. It's, yes. I'm sure you will get the hang of it, Lilo. Yeah, I am. Yeah. I mean, I think I am. Last time I checked, I was sure of it. Moving dirt is not the most exciting thing, I must admit. But, you know, it's the only tools that do this better are our very end game, and I'm quite some distance away from that. I think there should be something in between. So on the recent survey, I did suggest something in between, or possibly the ability to just, you know, while driving the wheelbarrow, to right-click and tip out a load, you know? I guess we'll see if any of those suggestions actually even get read, let alone considered as something they want to change. If I was a developer of a game, I'd be very precious about its functionality, because I'd for right or wrong, I'd want it to work a certain way and do a certain thing. So getting feedback is important, ultimately it's still your own vision, and I don't know, I would not want to feel compromised by having to change it away from what I intended it to be. That's possibly why I would make a terrible software designer. But at the same point, if you don't have a tight vision of what you want it to be, you lose your way. The same happens with any kind of design, I guess. If you don't have a tight vision of what you want it to be, you just lose your way. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, I need a couple more rows yet. Num, num, num. Num, num, num. Yes, I added the caption plugin like we have on yours, Alilo. I thought it was about time I did the same thing. Yep, I also installed a plugin called Tuner. Don't know why it's called. Sounds a bit fishy, doesn't it? And what that does is that reads the Spotify app to see what I'm currently playing and displays it as the little white text under the bar on the screen, because that's where I've chosen to put it. What? You had a... I don't... Oh, that was Soundtrack did that, but because of course Soundtrack is just too buggy, and I've got rid of it. But if you look under my goal bar now, you'll see a little white text. Yeah. Mhm. Yep. I have added it. Oh, I just had to pause for a second. Ooh, firebug. Right, I'm going to go through my DMCA-free, safe-to-use-on-stream-beats type music stuff and find something a bit more peppy. This is not quite peppied enough for me. This one's by the same people, but it's called Hype Tracks. High energy music to game to stream to and use in your YouTube montages. Yes, I'm using Stream Beats by Harris Heller. I'm not required to do any kind of a shout out or thank for it, or even announce the name on it, which is really cool. And it's all... it's all DMCA free. It's actually pretty good. Most of it is first party created music. All of it's beats, some of it lo-fi, some of it a bit more hype. And I think because they give it away so freely and because it's pretty decent quality, it makes you want to shout them out and say, hey, go check this out. But yeah, I think it's actually really, really awesome. Well worth a look at. They've got, if you just Google Stream Beats, you can play some beats directly from their website. Or you can link it through to, I think, Apple Music, Last.fm, definitely Spotify, because that's the interface I'm using for it. And you can just use it freely. IP freely. Yeah, it's been a lot of work to get this orchard set up right, but it did make me about 115 grand just in selling the fruit, and it should make me 133, I think it is, if I sort out all the fruit ratios and turn it all into fruit salad before selling. But fruit salad as well, really good food for the eating, so I shall keep some for eating and sell some, which is why I'm increasing the orchard size by double almost. Gonna go from rows of columns of 15 to columns of 30, I think. Yeah, John's just having a little look out in the ocean. He's all right. Yeah, he's having a little wade. Even though his name's John, he's having a wade. I've also looked at pretzel rocks before as well. I've watched some streamers that have pretzel on for the DMCA stuff. You do have to pay for that. It's about £7 UK a month, $10. There is a free tier, but it limits greatly the number of unique tracks you get. So if you do stream a lot, then obviously it's a bit more limiting. Frankly, if I was streaming all day every day, I would possibly pay for one of those types. It is having the Twitch soundtrack as an app where you could pick your mood and pick a specific playlist based on that was great, except of course Twitch soundtrack is scuffed and breaks OBS. So to get that, I think you'd have to be willing to pay a little bit of money for something. They do have an offer for $60 for a year, which is effectively a 50% discount as well with pretzel, which again is 50 quid. I mean, that's not a lot at all for what it gives you. Not that anyone asked any of my thoughts on stream music, but if anyone would like to talk about it, you're more than welcome to chime in or share a thought. Oh god, ignore that. Well, we can't. So Lilo keeps getting reminded by her phone company to choose an included extra. The only included extra that Lilo can choose is a 1 month free Disney Plus. We already have Disney Plus. And to get the 1 month free Disney Plus, you have to sign up for it through the phone company on a different account. You can't just add a month free to another account. You may have to sign up for it and then immediately cancel it just to make them piss off and stop bothering you, Lilo. Hey, Rachie, how's it going today? How is the Friday feeling hitting you? Good morning, evening. Yeah, I never remember time zones for people. I am terrible at that. So like we have pronouns on Twitch chat, I think we also need time zones so people can be like UTC minus plus whatever. It would be awesome to be, maybe I should write that, maybe that should be what I do. Go to the Aleo pronouns guy and just say, hey, can I have all of your code and database? I'm going to do an exact copy of your system for time zones. Thank you, Cindy. I will hydrate. Oh, have my captions stopped? Yes, they have. Stretch. And a bend. That's not good. Why have my captions stopped? Oh,
2 hours.
Oh, cool. Hello, captions. Hello. Hello, captions. Turn captions off. CC disabled. Turn captions on.
No!
Hello, captions. There we go. The captions are now working again. A drowsy. Do I have a drowsy? I've already done a pokey catch because of the automation. 3:30 a.m. So, our neighbor wakes up at that. Have a safe trip home, by the way, Cindy. Sorry. Chatty scrolly. One of our neighbours gets up at that time, and Lilo gets up at that time. But obviously it's not your local time zone, it's our local time zone. Yeah, Lilo needs to learn how to type, maybe. Is it just spelling, or I can't tell? My eyes don't work. Oh, I don't like this song. Let's skip that one. Hey Tigger. One shout out. That's a point, actually. Did Cindy get the automatic shout out? I need to check this. Yes, should have done. Yes, think. I like to be certain of things like this. Right, I need to BRB. That's back in a moment.
Transmission incoming from the Big Giant Head. Thank you for calling the Big Giant Head. He cares about you.
The sharpest tool in the shed.
Dadman is amazing. Unbelievable. Mind-blowing. Gonna make him wish that he could have clipped me. Mwah.
He's dead, Dave. Everybody is dead. Everybody is dead, Dave.
Wait. Are you trying to tell me everybody's dead?
Let him out in the first place.
How do you even know if you have proper posture?
So yeah, apparently I needed to posture check. I am trying to tell you that everyone's dead. Thanks, I am the best around. Very kind of you to notice. I am amazing, unbelievable, mind-blowing, and I did clip Lilo. Mwahaha. Also, hello, I'm the big giant head. This is your transition. Finally, Lilo apparently needs absolutely nothing. I'm all out of stock. I've run out of nothing. I just don't know. Don't know what to tell you. Also, does that mean I can karaoke Baby Shark?
DMCA.
Karaoke doesn't get counted as DMCA. No, it doesn't. Does it? You're just saying it because you don't want me to karaoke it. Baby Shark. How do you posture check a giant head? Wow, so you can't actually karaoke. Well, that's not good. So how do people live stream covers then? I guess they don't? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Perfect. Okay. So I can start filling in. You pay for the cover rights. Yeah, I guess. You'd be better off doing originals. Of course. I think there's an element of fair rights to the DMCA, like, unless you sing, like, the entire massive song, like, if you're just doing a rap from a big song or something like that, then, or a short clip, then, as far as I'm concerned, that's covered by fair rights. Also, DMCA, American thing, we're English, get naffed. That's all I can really say about that. I guess Twitch is an American company, so... So I don't just, like, spontaneously sing that much. Although, now and then, me and Lilo will just turn to each other. Or one of us will turn to the other. And we'll just belt out a frame. Yeah, I was singing Blink-182 yesterday. But also, Blink-182 is awesome. But yeah, I'm not as random songy as Lilo is, for sure. But yeah, sometimes I do just belt it out. However, you get me in the car, especially get me in the car on my own, I ramp up the volume and I absolutely belt out whatever I can, and it's terrifying, and no one should be forced to listen to that. That's why I only do it when I'm alone in the car. No, I didn't make any dinks because I'm moving dirt. We listen to Blink 182 all the time. Bottle brush gives you 20 hearts of health and 60 seconds of heart regen. Well worth me growing up my bottle brushes then. And Erwin is visiting the island and he can sell me creatures that I can farm. In the farm, I don't have yet. Oh, dog. Right, off we go. I mean, they're not mushroom trees. They're just mushrooms, I think, Lilo. And they're providing a moderate level of light. Although I'll probably go for the wooden... lampposts when I get there. Not actually sure what it takes to build them yet. I have batteries. I have light bulbs. And I have wood. I just don't think I've got the recipe. I'm assuming it comes from a license. But I do want to finish planning out my farm yet, so... I don't know, I mean, some of you will know last time I did streaming in anger, kind of on this pattern, after Lilo finishes for an hour or two. I just got really lost in it. I didn't like the content I was making, the games I was playing, and as I've mentioned a few times, the troll coming in with just a pointless throwaway comment, just at the time, with where my mental health was, it just really got to me, and I just made me think, what's the point? I don't like what I'm doing, so why bother doing it? But it has been, had been almost 3 months, and got in a better place with my meds, so I thought, well, maybe try another one, just a diddle one. And now look at all the dinks. Dinking all the time. Yeah, I appreciate the Lilo for buying the Dinkum for me. It was a very kind and generous gift. I did think when I saw it that I would like it. Yeah, it didn't seem to work very well. It was like, this is new, but I try a lot of games, and or sometimes I don't try a lot of games, and I just kind of give up straight away. If there isn't a fairly immediate hook for me, I'm just like, nah, not that one. Don't like that one. That one's not for me. Right, so we need 6 rows of these. That one's going to go away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this row will go away as well. So then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I need to make these 3 rows krangdongs. Bananas. I'll only do 4 of the rows there, and then I'll need to do 1, 2, 3, 4. So the lime trees will need to go away entirely. Then the apple trees go down to 4, and that's going to mean the lime trees end up being planted in here. Yeah, I moved the Pokemon so it's accidentally right on top of my bottom flappy mouth. It wasn't strictly intended, but it's what we've got. And you know, sometimes you just have to live with what you got. What, everyone has Premier Balls hanging around? You might just have to, like, set a second account up and then immediately cancel it, Lilo. Another message. I don't need a gun. I got a donk. A donk? What's a donk? I'm donk. That's a Crocodile Dundee quote. Sort of. I do like loads of random 80s and 90s film references and TV. Maybe I should make that one of my sound clips. I don't need a gun. I got a donk. You need more coffee because you didn't get the reference, or just because it's early in the morning? Oh, because you missed the Pokemon. Hey, Loke. Loki has decided to sit on my mouse hand. I'm going to have to yeet him out in a minute. So you're Aussie, right, Richie? Is it like it's not like looked down on as being really cliche or gauche or anything, is it?
American.
Or are you American? I don't know. California. I'm sorry. I thought you were Australian. But then I also thought Sweetener Sam was Australian. I'm like, oops. Now I've heard actual accent. Apologies for mistaking your country of origin, Richie. Lilo is indeed saying suck it to me for getting it wrong. No, that's why we need a time zone plugin. I don't know how the pronoun is stored. It must be in your Twitch metadata somewhere. I don't even know how it's done, so... I presume it's buried in your Twitch account and not just all in their website. But I don't really know. Well, that broke the captions. As in, they've just stopped completely now. There we go. It's back. The captions plugin is a bit glitchy for me. Just seems to randomly stop. Maybe it's my dodgy accent. It's like taking extra time to try and work out what the actual heck I'm going on about. Poor Google Cloud voice recognition. You're doing a very good job trying to understand me. Exactly, it's content in its own right. I didn't put it on for accuracy. I put it on for lulz. I'm not certain anyone could actually understand it. Now it's like, you know, super early in the morning. I just woke up. My mouse is not probably going to be right, but I should be about noon on Dadmin side of the world. Your mouse is pretty good. It is 11:50 a.m. for the Dadmin and the Lilo. At least until 2 a.m. on Sunday morning, when it becomes 1 a.m. for a second time, and our clocks go back. I'm not necessarily looking forward to the clocks going back. Yeah, it will become 2:30 Lilo time. We just need to push your meds out by half an hour, if we can. That's true. Yeah, cats are routine based. So they'll get you up anyway. One thing I want to know as well, is this Coriolis effect real? Does water go down the plug hole the opposite direction in Australia? We are indeed covered in cats. The why of it is not something I'm entirely sure I can answer. But they've moved in. Loki has moved in next to me, and he's kind of pressed his back up against my mouse hand, so I can't really control. And yeah, Harley is sat on Lilo's mouse. It's good that Lilo is in the sitting back and not giving too many Fs mode right now. Harley has been offered derpy cuddles and she got off. She smells funny, apparently. Harley is insist. She'll probably believe that as well. Lilo's holding up a blanket and pretending she's not there. Do cats have object permanence? We're going to science the heck out of this. I should also get that clip from that film as well. Time to science the heck out of it. Right, I'm going to sell some of my stuff. Come on, John. Buy my rubbish. Oh god, I just broke the captions again by talking in a silly accent. So cats do have object permanence. They know when you are hiding behind a sheet. Sounds good. I'm good. Right. Now, what did I else? I want another barbecue. That would make it three. No, I probably don't need another barbecue. I need another shovel. I have a chest literally full of almost completely broken tools. Hey, John, I'm supposed to talk to you. I wanted to chat. Let's chat. Secrets is trading low, buying high. You probably should have sold me that information. Yes. Hello, Theodore.
You have a museum?
Yeah. I have a museum. I built this on stream. And I donated some of the creatures on stream. There's a butterfly-arium here. There's a bee-arium here and beetles. And then desert area. It's pretty bad. And then there's a aquarium here, and I have precisely two fish in it. But I can only see. Oh, there's one anchovy, and then another thing. Cats, they know. They know when things are happening. They can tell. They know when they need to go and hide, like, mental floofy cases. Let's talk about the town. Can I see the deeds? Oh, I can build another one. Extra house deeds. So these can be used for multiplayer people to go in, but you can also use them as workshops. But I don't want any of them right now. They are not of the useful at this moment in time. Let's chat, because I get points for doing so. Fletch is actually my surname. Oh, what's your first name? I might tell you one day. Ha ha ha. Good for you. You tell me one day. Make 4,000 dink. There's me wheelbarrow. Have I got something else I can sell to make a bit more dink? Also, Craft a new tool. I don't really need to craft any tools right now. Right. Let's have that. That. Open more shells, and I'll have that butterfly. Let's go sell these to John and see if that makes the 4,000 I need. Yep, yep. Kittens, they can do that. I readily believe. 441, is that enough to take me over? No, it's still not enough. I'm good. Right, so let's sell him just one of those and just one of those. I think it, different cats definitely have different personality, obviously. Wow, that made a lot of money. Some are obviously naturally more nervous than others. Ivy is a super nervous cat. Super possessive of Lilo and super nervous. And she hides from everything. Sometimes if she hears the door going, she will run for it. Like, with the postie. She hears the postie interacting with the slot. She will come up and she will check to make sure that nothing dangerous is coming through the door slot for us, the mouse slot. Which is very kind and brave of her. And then other times, she'll just be under the bed. And you won't see her for love nor money. There will be nothing that can get her out of there. What? Nothing. Okay. I have so many nearly dead tools. I am waiting for the tool repairer. Yeah, ferals tend to be very nervous, obviously, because of their experiences out on the streets. Had a cat that could hear the car from about 2 blocks away. Yep. Cats do have the insane hearing. Sometimes our cats go and sit in the front window and tease the neighbor's dogs. Yeah, sometimes they come up to the window to watch me get out of the car, judging me as if to say, "You've been out. How dare you? Also, what did you bring us?" Draco will almost always come and find me after I've been out and come back. As if to say, "Oh, you're back. It's food time now. You brought me food, right? It's food, yeah? Yeah, I want the food. Have you got me the food yet?" He does. So Draco, I believe, I know, the noise he makes, I know he makes the noise, but the situation, no, you're right. But I know the type of noise he makes. Draco, I believe, was hand-reared, possibly as a previous rescue cat, and then he was found as a stray with no chip or collar. Bless him. So yeah, he doesn't meow properly. He just kind of goes pew, 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 bit like that. Loki's looking at me as if to say, "What are you doing, Dadmin?" I recommend not looking at them. C- Congratulations on the pokey catch. Should I sing that or will Persephone? Yes, that is how you say it, Lilo. God. No, no. I'm trying to fix the hole, not make it worse. My God. Shovel mechanics. They can be really glitchy. I hope that my feedback to the survey gets to the attention of the developer and that he can look at fixing that. Yes, I had to help you learn how to say Chipotle as well. It's like you're dyslexic with words sometimes. You just can't. And I say that without any hint of criticism. You just can't get it or memorize it. I've generally speaking, I mean, there are a few notable exceptions to words that I just get wrong. Generally speaking, I've always done this thing in my head where I break words phonetically. Up into blocks of threes and fours, threes and fours, or vowel sounds in my head, just as a tick, which I believe is part of my previously misdiagnosed or not noticed ADD. So I tend not to find spelling or pronunciation to be too bad, like I said, except for one or two notable exceptions, like Gal Gadot is Gal Gadot, not Gal Gadot. She's not bloody French. Yeah, it's Godot. No, actually, it's Godot because she's not French. And the soft vowel sound like that is a French pronunciation. So yeah, that was a bit of a derp on my part. Probably a couple of others that I can think of if I try. I don't really want to embarrass myself that much, so I shan't. Fair. Yeah. I don't stumble over Lilo's soon-to-be last name. You like what I did there, Lilo? But other people do. It's a word where, but sometimes it gets like different letters added on the start, like a, or you know the critical, you know, the critical letter in the middle. Sometimes that gets changed to a, from that to a. That was terrible at animating a Y with my fingers.
That was so bad.
I didn't even press the pause button. So yeah. Sometimes with at the start as well. And I'm just like, it's not that hard, people. What are you marrying into? You are marrying into your soulmate and love of your life, who will love you and cherish you.
Giant head. Thank you for calling the big giant head. He cares about you.
He cares about you. Yeah, we can be sickening, ain't it? Yeah, Lilo is not a fan of the PDA, therefore I PDA her often. Because she's lovely. And you got to desensitize yourself to a little bit. That's not an excuse for me not to tell the world that you're lovely. I'm sorry. Good try, but no. Okay, 11 more. I mean, I would sing I'm a dwarf and I'm digging a hole, except I'm not really digging a hole. I'm building a farm? I'm a dwarf and I'm digging a hole. Yeah, it probably could be. No, no, I did not click that time. I honestly didn't. Look, I really respect the amount of work it takes to go into a game, but I actually just didn't click then. In my response to the survey, I did send the developer a link to a VOD. And now I'm just hoping that I wasn't, like, critical or anything when describing the slightly glitchy shovel mechanics, and they don't, like, take it super personally. Because, yeah, I do really like the game, and I see myself playing it quite a lot for the near future. But also, please fix the shovel. I don't want to dig holes in the wrong place by accident, because it's not sure what I'm trying to do. Nom nom nom. Nom nom nom. There we go. Another wheelbarrow full. Hi John, why were you hiding behind the bush? Also, hey Irwin, please don't copy Steve Irwin. Scoop, scoop, dig, dig, scoop, scoop. Dig, dig. It is kind of relaxing doing this. And it's the main reason why I've let myself do it with early game tools instead of, you know, waiting for the power tools at the end. I can use those to do different projects then. Very raining. It's quite good rain sounds in this. I've not had a thundery day, I don't think, but there is possibility for thunder days. One thing I was thinking about was building this here in at the southern teleport tower, which is just here. Building this is like the main island city, and then at each of the teleport towers, so there's one about there on this map, there's one somewhere around here with all the death birds, and there's one, I think it's actually on this little outcrop here. I was thinking about using the additional guest houses to park right next to the towers, so you could have like a little outpost. just with a bed in it and maybe like a table and a chair or something. And then I need to start like putting bridges in to cross all the rivers properly instead of swimming through them and that kind of jazz. But again, I'll probably wait for the more endgame power tools for that, because I'll need to like part build causeways, because the bridges only have a maximum span limit of so many blocks. Yeah, I thought so. And then you can, each one of the additional houses is, I think, is a slightly different color, or you can decorate differently. But it's, I mean, it doesn't have to be anything, or because I think the teleporting is free once you unlock the towers. If it's not, then I'll rethink those plans slightly. But if it is free once the towers are unlocked, then I could split my workshop around. So I could have one full of kegs with a bedroll. I could have one near the farm, which does all the stuff with the seeds. I could have one with all the furnaces and stuff. I could have another one for cooking. I mean, I don't know exactly. Don't know if I'll actually use them that much. I've not done enough in the deep mine yet to know whether I really need that high a supply of iron for the danger, or whether I can get away perhaps with just waiting and looking for the rare spawns of iron and opal on the surface. So as you get into the more powerful tools, it seems to unlock spawns of the rarer ores on the top as well. So when I first started, you could barely find iron, and there wasn't a lot of tin around either. Now that I've got iron tools, there's so much tin, fair chunk of copper, and you can find enough iron to get by. And I even found an opal. Out on the surface as well, just like in a node, in an ore node. So it definitely seems to respond in some way to your gaming. What way that is, I guess I'm not really sure. A vullaby. What is that? Jesus Christ. It looks like Dr. Eggman as a Pokemon, sort of.
Really not.
No?
No.
Looks scary AF, I'll tell you that much. I should actually crop all of these trees, and this hurts my hands. Can at least hold down the right click when it's time to collect, which is a handy little trick. You can't hold down the right click to make the harvest, which is not so handy. It's a vulture Pokemon. Yeah. But it looks like a vulture in a power suit. It looks really dangerous. I think that's all of... Oh no, there's one more tree there. Okay. So yeah, being so close together, it's really tricky to actually just get in there and harvest them, as you may now see. Yes, and so do you, Persephone. Well done. So yeah, my idea being that with the chain structure, you'll have a wooden path like this between every row, and you'll just be able to walk up and down like this. Bananas in pajamas are running down the stairs. Lots of lime as well. So I don't know if it's an intended mechanic that you can actually do this, but because every single fruit that you harvest from all of these fruit trees can then be planted to make another tree, I have. Because one tree drops kind of 2, 3, or 4 fruit depending on the type of tree, you can therefore obviously multiply its impact quite significantly. Apples are the most insane. 75 apple trees drops 300 fruit. There's some pretty good coding in this engine because it can tolerate having all of this on the ground without dropping my frame rate significantly. I don't know if you'd fare so well on a console version. But possibly, if they've optimized the engine, they've optimized the engine, and that's that. I believe it's Unity under the skin, so a mobile version's even possible. Assuming you can figure out how to make the controls work. Miss one. Miss two. But yeah, clumping them together like that just makes it hard to see which ones you've missed, which ones you've got, and how to harvest them. But bouncing around in the treetops like that was quite fun. So that only made 256 there, so I must have missed a couple of trees. Ooh, it's gone to late. Right, time for bed. I'm going to keep all of those ready for replanting and extending the orchard instead of selling them. Oh. Boing. I'm getting lots of stock. Being able to like shift and right click and just type in a number of them to take off a stack would probably be helpful. But having said that, not even Stardew does that. You have to install a mod to get that. But it would be handy. Shmodded. Yeah, I have not got any animals yet, or any crops really. Hokidokiri. So I need to get rid of all of these now, because they burn your toes, and I have got campfire. I've got barbecues instead. Thank you, yes. It didn't quite suit me, though, I must admit. I don't have the thighs to carry it off. So if I make that bananas, and then put another row of bananas somewhere over here, then that probably will even things out a bit more. Possibly. So, coconuts. I don't want to hack out any of these coconuts yet, but eventually... path... I can put the path in where it's going to be. So that's going to be 1, 2. So this is going to be path. Which means then this is going to be path. It's a little bit bothering, yeah. But the problem is you don't get to pick with those trees. Also, look. I can't get through. Now I can get through, but only if I glitch really hard. It doesn't matter. It's picked at random, I think, based on when you use the shovel. It kind of shoves them in one direction or t'other. A bit early. Mm-hmm. Fair enough. Lilo's gone and flopped out on the chaise lounge of part of the sofa. Just getting comfy is all I was really indicating, Lilo. Yarb. Harley has decided to use the opportunity to summon Lilo's hand for attention. So we're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this row also needs to go away. Let's save some durability of the axe and drink a wattle brew. And then this one goes away. Thank you very much for redeeming a stretch and a hydrate. It's a twofer. I will stretch and I will hydrate. Thank you. Ugh. And a drink. Ah. Nom nom nom. Okay, so these were lime bushes, these were coconut. I need I'm gonna plant a few coconuts so I can donate denote the lines of coconut trees. You did improv a song for Harley. Can you see, Lilo, how the coconuts have just kind of picked a random generation, generation direction? I do not have the control over the situation. Wow, my phone does not like my face with a headset over it. Just a spam email. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So that'll be the end of the row. Not there, thank you. Have good meds. See you in a minute. Okay, so that's my grid set up.
Thank you. You love me. You really love me.
Thank you very much. Very kind. I appreciate it a whole heck of a lot. And Katon, you will hopefully notice that you have access to all of the awesome sloth emotes. I hope you enjoy them. Get good use out of them. They are very cute in my opinion, which is why I chose them. And that also brings us one more closer to thanks for saying thanks. You're welcome. That also brings us one more closer to my goal of getting another remote animated and static slots, which will be incredibly fun. I've got plenty more of the sloth emotes waiting for an outing for when we get there. Yes, thank you again. What is this? It's a sarcophagus Pokemon. What? What? I don't even know what to make of that. It's like, I'm assuming it's a ghost Pokemon because it's got four ghostly hands coming out of the sarcophagus. That's just, that's special, that is. That's special. Anyway, get your Pokecatches out if you would like this. You know what? I'm going to be generous and I'm going to go around to Lilo's screen and I'm going to type Pokecatch Ultra Ball for Lilo in case Lilo does not have the this one. There we go. Pokecatch Ultra Ball. There we go. Yeah, that's a Pokemon, all right. Sarcophagus ghost Pokemon. There is supposed to be a like a companion bot for this, which will type in chat the info of the Pokemon. It'll tell you Cofrigus, the ghost sarcophagus Pokemon. A bit like the Pokédex entry, but I've tried a few times to find out what it is. Can't seem to find it. It's a bit like Isabel says for AC&H, but for the PCG. Unfortunately, I wasted an Ultra Ball on your behalf, Lilo. I'm sorry about that. It was a ghost sarcophagus Pokemon, and I tried to catch it in your name. But it didn't work. That's right, Harley. It didn't work, and we are very upset about that. Oop. That one's already planted. So yeah, you don't get to choose, unfortunately. They just all go in all random directions. I don't really like the animation of them either. It looks a bit wooed. So that's got my six rows of coconut trees straightened out. So they might need eight, but they're not in the ratio. So I'm just going to leave them at six and deal with it. So this is lime trees, and I need six of lime trees. So I've got three here. That'll be two more there. So I'm going to have to take out this row of banana armors. Five bananas. I kind of wish I wasn't doing this because I don't have as many bananas as the rest. But I've got a boost on and I don't want to waste it. So then that's two rows of bananas there and another two rows of bananas there. And then I think this is crangdons. So basically I have to take out this entire plantation here of crangdons. Because I need eight rows of bananas. But I am wondering if I actually just put some on the other end and just don't have them all sequential. Because I don't think it matters if my orchard isn't all just uniform lines. It can be mixed up a bit more. Lilo says there must be order. Okay, I take orders from the boss. I add order by order.
Transmission incoming from the Big Giant Head. Thank you.
That is
for
really
calling
a good
the Big Giant Head. He cares about you.
So that's going to be lime as well. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 5. That'll be 5 and 6. So that was 5. This will make 6. Just hope I have enough health left in this iron axe to finish all of this. So that's 6. This row needs to come out anyway. Hey Loki. Yeah, essentially this entire row needed to come out. Still got 37 seconds. So I can take out this row here and then cry. Oh no, I broke the axe. That was an iron axe. Oops. Sloops. Yeah, I should have been a bit more careful with that. Iron ore. I've only got one iron bar left as well. 2, 3. Oh no! What did I do? Copper bars. Where did they go? They went there. Don't want them. Want that. Not that crate, this crate. Next axe. So I have enough fruit possibly to make my entire orchard, but then not a lot more. don't really want to waste cooked meat, so we're going to cook all of these cactus figs because no one cares about cactus figs. Barbecues against a windmill are very quick. I dare say if you had three, you would struggle to keep all three full. That sounds like a challenge. That's 50 cooked cactus figs. I don't want to use them all, but you can't replant them, so I don't really know what to do other than just eat them and save a few. Let's go see if the iron's ready. Yes, it is. Doo-boo-doo-bump. I did not mean to break that. I'll have to put it back. Pants. Okay, so I want to put the correct type of fruit at the top of every row so I know what's going in the rest of the row. So, but I better go and buy another shovel from... And I'll be alright for one day. No, I'm going to plant it. I'm not just going to throw it on the floor, don't worry. So that's 6 rows of lime, 6 rows of coconut, now 8 rows of banana. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's 8 rows of banana. Possibly thinking I might just add a 7th row of coconuts on the end here and just push the path out by one. Because again, the ratio of those don't matter, but it'll make it so all rows are 2 instead of just a random 1 on the end, which I should have thought about before hacking everything apart and replanting, but there you go. I was mostly thinking of not going up and down the outside. No, we're adding an extra row. It's going to be done. The ratio for these does not matter. It's extra money. I might even do another row of 2 of these on the very other end. Or even 3, because they're just pure money. Yep. Hello? Might be because my mic was muted there.
Really?
Yeah, I think so. It didn't unmute properly. I've been talking for a while. I mean, there was no way people could have heard it. I was talking. So yeah, that was a thing that happened. Sorry about that, everyone. It's just... sometimes my mic doesn't properly unmute. The arm is a bit wonky. Yeah, I've been talking away for the last 10 or 15 minutes and you've probably not had a clue what I was saying or doing or anything. Just no wobbly head. Just the game. So I was just saying, yeah, Lilo can hear me just fine. Poor her. I was saying, Coffee Shan, hello, welcome in, and all of that jazz. And asking you how your weekend was, I did a long, rambly speech about how ours is going to be nice with kids, and I can't remember any of it, sorry. No, I just broke it. Maybe I should put a little note on the screen saying, the microphone is muted, tell Dabmin, he might not know. I can possibly have that text appear every time the microphone is muted and it just says, microphone's currently muted, can you just check if he meant to do that? That's how scuffed I am at it. So yeah, sorry about that. Thanks for everything that everyone does. I appreciate you being here. I'm a pro. My name is Marv and I am Dabmin. And I am also extremely embarrassed. Yeah, maybe that's what we'll do. Tell you what, let's make it now. New channel reward. Hey, Marv, are you supposed to be muted? Require viewer to enter text. No. Cost 1 point. Redemption cooldown. I don't know. 15 seconds. Effect. Sends an announcement to your chat. Hey, Dadmin. You might be muted. You der brain. There we go. That now exists. If anyone would like to do that. Yeah, look, I've got a red face from embarrassment. If anyone would like to test the redemption, it has a 10 second cooldown. Hey, Dabmin, you might be muted, you der brain. I'm not muted. Thank you for checking. Think it'll work? It might work. Lilo had a surprised look on her face that I called myself a der brain. I think it's quite fair. It was pretty derpy. No wonder I'm getting angry at the captions for not being able to understand me. It literally can't understand me. Yeah, that face. That's exactly what Lilo did. Real life, that face. My orchard will be good when it's finished. It'll grow lots of things. So, I need to take out another row of apples. we already know that you guys do not come here for the pro gamer. I am the dirt. What am I going to do when it's finished? I'm going to make another orchard. Change it again. Probably. See, there's one I missed. Harvest. Saving that one for later. I have hit it, thank you, love. There we go. So, we've got our ratio sorted out. So we've got 6 of lime, 8 of banana. Then I'm going to do 4 of apple here. So let's put another apple tree down. So I don't forget what's in fact. I can probably do this entire row of apples. It's only one row. So what's next after this, once this makes me some more money, is animal husbandry. I think I'll probably build out the animal farm. Or maybe crops, I don't know. We'll see how close I am to sprinklers, water towers. But I have to kind of get to summer again before I can get melons to make scarecrow. So I'm not going to be able to do any serious amount of farming until I have that. Because traps will only go so far and birds will still get the seeds. This will actually be the first time I've tried to make things look nice instead of just neat and tidy. Like, I'm trying neat and tidy and nice, which is kind of new for me. So we have fingers crossed. I have fingers crossed. I am not some emperor that speaks in the royal we. Okay, so then Quangdons go here. No, that didn't work. This is fiddly. Bit of patience, you get there eventually. Yeah, I must say, for being in winter, it's not very wintry. The stuff blown around just feels a bit like autumn, maybe? I don't know if stronger weather effects are on the roadmap or not. Don't even know if there is a roadmap published for this one. But yeah, it could be a bit more wintry. Yeah. Like, except for it saying on there, you can see like more wind effects, but then some days are windy and some aren't, so that isn't necessarily telling anyway. May as well try and plant some more banana armors as well. So maybe one day for science we should wait and see if late turns into really late and then forces you to pass out. It just limits your stamina as far as we've pushed it. But it might let you go all the way. Bananas in pajamas are running down the stairs. Even though I might not get it finished in this game day, I definitely want to get these bananas in because they do only make 2 fruit per tree and I need to get their production up to the level of the rest. This will possibly be the last row I can put in before having to find a new bedroll. I sincerely hope your head does not explode. I'll get that, if you like. Postie's just been. Sec. Alrighty, oh. Nope, I didn't mean to do that. I can aim. Right, let's plant some banana armors. Yeah, my house is just 3 barrels in the bed. I've not got any cosmetic items for the house yet. So, in order to be able to afford all of that, you have to put in the hard work getting your produce, and then you have to do jobs for the people so they move in. And then you can buy the stuff off them to decorate. I literally have a piggy bank and a table, which I could put in the house if you would like me to. Oh, and a spare bedroll, just in case I've got guests. But yes, Coffee Shan, as you can see, I do have the priorities. I like the positional sound on this. Like when I'm shoveling to the right, it sounds out of my right ear. Of course, I don't actually have my right ear fully in, so I can hear Lilo in the room. So it just sounds like really echoey and quiet. But it's nice. An octillery. I imagine. Oh yeah. Thanks. What was I going to say? Yes, it will do that on your speakers, Tigger. An octillery. What does the octillery look like? It looks like... It looks like the episode of David Tennant Doctor with Martha with... no, wait. That's not right. The David Tennant episode with the weird smart guy and the baldy potato head people. And no, wait, no, that's not right either. The Invasion of the Cubes with Matt Smith. Yes, that's what it looks like. Or does it look like, Mummy, are you my mummy, Mummy? It might even look a bit like, Mummy, are you my mummy? The Evasion of the Light-Up Cubes also had a couple of hospital orderlies that had mouths that just kind of had vents on the end like that. And the nose and the mouth was just a grill. And they hid it behind surgical masks. Took me a few tries to remember. But I remembered. No, I didn't mean to do that. Dig, dig. Nope, I didn't mean to do that neither. Stream Elements would like to sponsor me for HelloFresh. I don't know. Is anyone here? Are you actually going to sign up for HelloFresh if either of us did something like that? Because we keep getting offered it. And we keep being like, nah, I don't think any of us are really financially mobile enough to sign up for HelloFresh. Yeah, well, the reason they stalker vibed you is because, you know, you're a much bigger streamer than me. Me, I just get like the check in on the dashboard if you can be bothered to find out what it is, bro. But they really want people to do it. And I really don't. I'm just not at all interested. I know, and that's the problem. Loads do it, which waters down the amount of people who will actually do it. Have good therapy. I was telling Lilo yesterday about a collectible shop in town. But they used an A instead of an I. So instead of collectibles, it's collectables. And we just can't even. They're not collecting tables, I don't think. Yeah, exactly. The OCD of the name is just too high. It's like, no. No. The wrongness. Yeah, collect able, maybe. Either way, I don't collect tables, and their inability to spell doesn't make me able to do anything. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So that's 8. So then this lot over here. Oh. Oi, oi, oi. That was a clonking of a car door, but I don't know if it was the car door we care about. Let me check for you. No, nothing's. It's neighbour in garage. It's neighbour in garage. They're about to leaf hoover, I think. Yeah. Alright, we're going to finish up there. Mini Lilo will be here soon, and I need a break from computering. Brand new raid message with brand new joke, and we're going to head over to AC Manda. Thank you very much, and have a wonderful weekend. See you all on Monday. Bye for now.